Hello everyone and welcome back to Unacademy platform. So myself Dr. Muskan Chaudhary and I will be your mentor for NEET PG Microbiology. So let's crack NEET PG. Before starting today, the leftover topic from the yesterday, the few points about the nematode, and we'll do a quick revision and wrap up the session. And as we know that the Unacademy is the India's largest learning platform with by the topmost educator with quality content and great learning experience, and with that it gives the daily live classes in which the student and the educator can interact with themselves, can do the answer polling, can ask their doubts and the queries, and the tests and quizzes are being provided that are being created or according to the exam criteria, and in which the student can analyze their performance, can evaluate their preparation, so that actually he can overcome his fear of anxiety and the panic before appearing for the real exam. Right, other than this, the student can keep the sessions recorded so that whenever in case the student is working as a doctor doing the JR ship, he can actually watch the content and can keep the sessions recorded so that he can hold over the topic and make a grip over the topic in case he do not get the actual good quality of the time for the studies. Right, and with this, the Unacademy provides the structured courses. Now, as we know, to complete the whole 19 subjects in a span of the 5.5 to 6 years, something is a great deal, and to cover the same 19 subjects within 8 to 9 months is something for their structured study. The smart study along with the hard work is something that is needed, and the structured course is that is provided by the topmost educators on the Unacademy platform. And I will recommend you to have at least 1 to 2 year subscriptions. Now, one is subscriptions mainly for those students who are the interns and the post interns or are the droppers, and the two subscriptions mainly for those who are working as a doing the JR ship and who are working and do not get the good quality time for the studies, and they shall have a two year. The subscription in case they do not get the desired rank this year, so that they can actually think of the next year as well. Right, other than this, the 1 year, 1 month, 3 months and 6 month packages are do available, and please do use my code, that is Muskan, to get 10% of discount. And as you can see, after discount for the 1 year, it actually cost about 22,500, and for the 2 year it cost about 27,000. Right, and compared to other, it is very cheap and economical compared to other platforms. So starting with the general characteristics of the nematodes. Yesterday we read about the cystoid, trematode and the nematodes. And the cystoids were what? They were segmented, while the rest two were unsegmented. And apart from this, the trematodes are what? The leaf-like, you know? And nematodes, they are the roundworms. Right, so what are the general characteristics of the nematodes? They are unsegmented, elongated and the cylindrical, right? They are separate sexes are present, and GIT is complete, body cavity is complete. No need to remember these points, but do remember that they are unsegmented and cylindrical in the shape. Now, what are the helminths are included in the nematodes? These are Ascaris, Nikita Americans, Trichura Trichura, Antrobius Vermicularis, Dracunanculus Medinensis. Right, so Ascaris lumbricoides, ankylostoma duodenum, Nicator americans, Trichura, Trichura, Antrobius vermicularis, and the Dracunculus medinensis. Now, what are the other common names? As we had read yesterday also, ki trematodes or the cystodes, cystodes ke bhi other names that we have to keep in mind. Now, Ascaris lumbricoides is the common roundworm. Ankylostoma duodenum is the old world or hookworm. Nicator americans is the new world or the American worm. Now Trichura, it is the whiff worm. Antrobius is the thread or the pin worm. Dracunculus, it is guinea worm. Other than this one is the strongyloids. Now, Ascaris lumbricoides is what? The common roundworm. And Ankylostoma duodenum is the old world hook or hookworm. Nicator americans is the new world worm. And the Trichura is the whip worm. And the Antrobius vermicularis is the thread or the pinworm. And Dracunculus is the guinea worm. So these are the common names. Now, the drug of choice for all the nematodes is what? Albendazole. But we also do have exception. Yesterday we read that for the trematodes and the cystodes, the drug of choice was praziquantel. But what's the exception? One was the echinococcus echinococcus within the cystode, and in the trematodes, we also read the drug of the choice was the praziquantel. Okay, now coming to the intestinal nematodes. Now we do have to keep in remember that what are the helminths that are reside in the small intestine and the large intestine. Now how to remember this? Remember ki large intestine just remember this, the light is the othia. Now how to remember ki light, L-I-T-E, that is the large intestine. Now T-E is what? Trichura and the Antrobius vermicularis. ठीक है तो लाइट इन द लाइट द एल आई इज व्हाट द लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन एंड टी इज द ट्राइचुरा एंड द एंट्रोबियस वर्मिकुलरिस एंड द हैज व्हाट इज द हैज ये आएगा अपना स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन में एंड हैज में क्या आ रहा है हुक वॉर्म What was the hookworm? One was the old world hookworm and the new world hookworm. That was the old world kya tha? Ankylostoma duodenum. And the new world was the Nicator americans and A4 Ascaris lumbricoides and S4 strongyloids. Okay, so light has otho. Now it is the large intestine, trichura, antrobius, and has for small intestine, that is the hookworm, ankylostoma, and the strongyloids. And what is the othio? Now othio is O4 oviparous, and thia is for thea, that is the trichura, e for antrobius, h for hookworm, and A for Ascaris. Okay, so Othia is the oviparous for Trichura, hookworm, that is Ankylostoma duodenum and the Nicator americans, and Antrobius and the Ascaris lumbricoides. We also read what are the examples of the this oviparous and the this viviparous, but they are just one, two, so easy to remember, and the oviparous has the four examples. Now moving next, Now this is the classification according whether they produce egg or they produce the larva, right? So we just read about the oviparous, that is the lay eggs that which hatch out later to larva. And what was the this othio? Now what were the oviparous helminths? That is the T4 trichura, trichura, hookworm, antrobius formicularis and the ascaris, right? Now another is the viviparous, that is the lay larva. And what is the example? That is the trichinella and dracunanculus, right? And another was the oviviparous, and what is the example? That is the one single example, that is the strongyloids. So for the oviparous, how did we remember the othia? That is the oviparous is the this trichura, trichura, H for hookworm, E for antrobius, and A for is what, ankylostoma. And viviparous, two examples, one is the trichinella and the dragonanculus, and the oviparous single example, that is the strongyloids. Okay, now moving next. Now before that, we'll make a table. As I told yesterday, that we'll make a table for the definitive and the intermediate host, combining all the cystoid, trematode and the nematodes, that is the definitive host and the intermediate host. Now if you remember for the yesterday's class, okay, Plasmodium, Toxoplasma gondii, Echinococcus, the man is not the definitive host. So what is man? Man is the intermediate host. And what are the definitive hosts for the Plasmodium? That is the mosquito Anopheles, and Toxoplasma gondii ke liye cat, and the Echinococcus ke liye dog, right? Now moving next, another examples. Now for the Leishmania, man is the for all others, the man will be the definitive host and the sand fly is the intermediate host. For the Trypanosoma, we did two, Trypanosoma brucei and the Trypanosoma cruzi, right? And man is again, what the man is definitive host. But you remember cruzi, the Chagas disease, the Ramona sign is present in what? The Red Wing Bug is the intermediate host, and the CC fly, Phlebotomus, is the intermediate host for the brucei. Another is the Taenia solium and the Taenia saginata. Now Taenia solium O comes, so therefore pork, that is the pig. So pig is the intermediate host. In the remaining, the cattle is the intermediate host and man is the definitive host. Now H nana was what, also known as the dwarf tapeworm. That is, a nana means chota, dwarf tapeworm. And for the H nana, man is again the definitive host. And for the H diminuta, for the H nana, only one host is present, and H diminuta, that is a man, is the definitive host, and the rat flea is the intermediate host, right? And for the Trichinellus spiralis, the man is again the definitive host and the pig is the intermediate host, right? So these are the, this is the table for the definitive host and intermediate host. We also read about the two intermediate hosts. We'll make a table about that later as well. Now moving to the Chandler's index. Now Chandler index is done for the hookworm, that is Ankylostoma, Duodenum and the Nicator Americans. And what do we do? We actually see the egg per gram of the stool. So in case if a Chandler index is less than 200, so the hookworm is not of much significance, but in case it is 200 to 550, then it is considered as the potential danger. Right, and for 250 to 350, 300 is what is actually a public health problem, and above 300 is an important public health problem. Just remember that below 200 it is not of much significance, but once it rises above the 200, it becomes a potential danger. So it is a Chandler index, and we do it for the hookworm to see the x per gram of the stool. Now also one more thing, that the infective stage for the ankylostoma and Ankylostoma duodenum and the strongyloids is the filariform larva. While for the rest, they are egg. Now, what is Vakana's disease? Vakana's disease is seen in the ankylostoma, but not in the Nikita. Now, important one is the Chandler index. That Chandler index is done for the hookworm, and we actually see the egg per gram of the stool. Remember, less than 200, it is not of much clinical significance, but once it rises about 200, it is of potential danger, right? So, we'll see as overview of the cycle. Now, Trichura, Antrobis, and Ascaris, a mode of transmission is what? Is the oral. And the infective stage, as I told you, is the aborted egg. Apart from the ankylostoma and the strongyloids, the mode of infective form is the this filariform larva. We also read yesterday in the trematodes what was the metacercaria larva was the infective form for all. And cystoid, we made a table according to larva stage that is the present. Now they develop into the larva. They develop into the adult and fertilize and lay the embryonated egg. And Antrobius, they develop to the embryonated egg in the feces, and they can cause the autoinfection. Now, in autoinfection has a mnemonic to remember. What are the helminths that cause the autoinfection, right? And this develop to larva. The Ascaris then moves to the lungs, and they swallow up the sputum. They again cause the autoinfection. And in the Trichura, the embryonated egg is passed in the feces. In case the life cycle of this is not important, but do remember the infective form for them. Now again here, the strongyloids and the hookworm, as I told you, the infective form is what? The filariform larva. Right, they will move to the skin, to the lungs, and they will reach to the GIT. The hookworm will develop from the male and the female, and the unembryonated egg will pass into the feces. In the strongyloids, the larva will develop in the adult, and female egg acts directly without any fertilization. Right, and this is the developmental cycle of the strongyloids that transform into L2 and to the L3. Now, L3 is the microfilary form, while the L1 is the rabditiform larva, right? And similarly in the hookworm. Now remember that L1 is the rabditiform larva, now coming one is the hyperinfection syndrome. Now what is the hyperinfection syndrome? Now repeated autoinfection leads to the heavy filariform larva, in the body. Now most important risk factor is what? The glucocorticoid therapy, and the IgE level rises. The larva may even go to the GIT and the migrate to the various organs like CNS, liver and the kidney, and the passage of the enteric flora to a disrupted mucosa leads to the gram-negative sepsis. Now CNS invasion, brain abscess and meningitis are the common, and the larva can even be seen in the CSF. So what is the important point? That the hyperinfection syndrome, they is due to the heavy load of the filariform larva, and the filariform larva was the infective stage for the hookworm and the strongyloids. And the most important risk factor is the glucocorticoid patient on the glucocorticoid therapy. Right, as I told you that the albendazole is the drug of the choice for all the nematodes, and for the trematodes and the cystodes we saw that the praziquantel is the drug of the choice, with the exception echinococcus have the albendazole as the drug of the choice. Here as well the drug of the choice, that is the albendazole, and exception is for the anthrobius it is the mebendazole, from the strongyloids it is ivermectin. For the Wuchuria is the DEC, that is diethyl carbamazine, and onchocerca and the strongyloids have the same, that is the ivermectin, and the anthrobius and dracunculus is the metronidazole. So for the anthrobius and the dracunculus it is a metronidazole, and for the strongyloids and the onchocerca it is ivermectin, and for the Wuchuria it is the DEC. Now this is important to remember, the drug of the choice. Now this is the rhabdity form larva, that is the L3 form of the cycle, and this is the microfilariform larva. Now one more point, that the microfilariform larva is the developmental stage of the life cycle and it is not infective. The filariform larva is the infective. Now coming to the filarial nematodes, we'll read filaria, we'll read the blood filariasis and the cutaneous. Now as I told you, infective form is what the filariform larva here as well, and it is transmitted by the mosquito bite. Now the L3 larva, that is the filariform larva. Now L1 was the rhabdity form larva. And L3 is the filariform larva, and the filariform larva is the infective form for the hookworms and the strongyloids and the filarial nematodes. Now the L3 will migrate to what? To the lymphatics, to the lymph nodes, and they will transport into the adult. Right, and we saw that the in case of the strongyloids and the hookworm, the L1 was the rhabdity form, and that converted into the L2 and transformed into the again L3 form, and the L3 form here was the filariform larva. While here the L form is the life cycle, first form is the microfilariform. Now in case do not remember, not you can skip this point. Now one thing is important, that the infective form is the filariform, and filariform is also infective for the hookworm and the strongyloids, and for the others it was the egg form, amniotic egg, that was the infective. Now what are the important lymphatic filariasis? That is the Wuchereria, Bancrofti, Brugia malai, and Timori. Now habitat is all for them, all it is the lymphatic tissue, and the microfilariform that is released, they will move into the blood. Right, and what is the vector? It is the Culex and the Anopheles, and for the Wuchereria, for the Brugia it is the Anopheles, and the for the Timori it is the Barbirostris. Now important, what are the examples of the lymphatic filariasis? So Wuchereria ho gaya, Brugia malai, and the Brugia timori. And now moving to the subcutaneous, what are the examples of subcutaneous filariasis? That is a lower lower, onchocercosis volvulus and the Mansolena streptocerca. And for the serous cavities, the Mansolena pertens and the Mansolena ozati. Also remember that just in case the names are important, that for the lymphatic filariasis, it is the Wuchereria bonecrafti and the Brugia. And for the subcutaneous, it is the lower lower and the onchocerca volvulus. Now moving next, the microfilari, as I told you that the microfilari are not pathogenic, but they are discharged into the blood and they have the triad of the pathogenesis, that is the dilatation of the lymphatic vessel, lymph adenitis, and the due to the presence of the in the lymph this lymphatics due to presence of the worms, that is the obstruction of the lymph nodes, right? So what is the triad of the pathogenesis? And the adult female wall is responsible for the crucial plays a crucial role in the pathogenesis, while the microfilari are not pathogenic and the filariform is pathogenic is infective. And what is the triad of the pathogenesis? Is the dilatation of the lymphatic vessels, lymph adenitis, and obstruction of the lymph nodes. Now, what is the clinical presentation? One is the endemic, that is the asymptomatic, because no microfilari is present in the blood and occurs due to insufficient exposure. And asymptomatic, that is a microfilari will be present in the blood but no clinical features, right? And this is TH1 is down regulated. Now acute, due to antigens released by the female adult worms, and the female adult worms is responsible for the triad of the pathogenesis, leading to the high grade fever, inflammation, and the chronic filariasis, that is after 10 to 15 years of acute phase, leading by to the lymphatic varices, hydrocele, elephantiasis, due to obstruction of the continuous lymphatic vessels, granuloma of the female breast, and the chyluria. Due to obstruction of the lymphatic vessels in the kidney and the abdomen. Now some basic difference between the classical and the occult filariasis. Now, classical, what is a causative agent is due to the inflammatory changes to the adult worm, while in the occult, it is the hypersensitivity reaction to the microfilari. For the classical, as I told you, the adult female worm is responsible for the pathogenesis, and in case of the occult, it is due to the hypersensitivity of the person to the microfilari form larva. Now diagnostic is same, that the microfilariform is present in the blood while it is not present in the blood, and the organs are affected because it is occult filariasis. Microfilariform are not present in the blood because they are present in the organs. So the organs affected will be the lungs, liver, and the spleen. And pathology, they will present with the lymphangitis and lymphadenitis, because the main organs that are infected are the lymph nodes, and here it is eosinophilic granuloma due to the hypersensitivity, right? So what is the common difference? Classical filariasis, as we saw, filariasis mein kya hota hai, pathogenesis ke liye adult form responsible hota hai, and because adult form, therefore causative agent which causes the classical filariasis, the inflammatory changes in the person to the adult form. Jabki occult mein kya hota hai, microfilari form larva ke against hypersensitivity reaction. And the diagnostic in the classical, as I told you, that the adult form is responsible for the pathogenesis, and in the blood the microfilariform larva is present, hai na? And therefore it is diagnostic to see the microfilariform larva in the blood, and the microfilariform here in the occult filariasis is present in the organ, or for the organ that the filariform larva is present in the organ. So the microfilariform larva will not be present in the blood, and they will be present in the organs, and therefore the organs they will be the affected, while here they are present in the lymph node causing the obstructions of the lymphatics. Therefore, the lymph nodes and the lymphatic vessels are affected. And the pathology is because the lymph nodes are affected, therefore leading to the lymphangitis. And here, leading to the hypersensitivity, leading to the eosinophilic granuloma. Now, IgG is a diagnostic antibody because they will be increased. Here, antibody will not be diagnostic because here it is hypersensitivity reaction. Therefore, IgE will be diagnostic. And O4O, that is the organs are affected. Therefore, the microfilariae is not released into the blood. They are present in the organs. And occult filariasis is also known as the Wingartten syndrome. Right, so occult filariasis is also known as the Wingartten syndrome, and the tropical pulmonary eosinophilia in the occult filariasis is also known as the Meyers-Kovner syndrome. Right, and the Wingartten syndrome is also occurs in the occult filariasis. Now, moving next to the trichinella. Now, we have read that for the trichinella, what was the intermediate host? The pig. The pig was the intermediate host, while the man is a definitive host and man is a dead end host, right? And what is the mode? Because pig is involved, therefore by the ingestion of the raw or uncooked pork. And what happens? The larva that penetrates into the intestine, they migrate actually to the muscle. It is important to remember that the migrates to the muscle, where it undergoes the cystation, right? And what is the most common muscle that is involved is of extraocular muscle, followed by the biceps and by the jaw and the neck. Right, so extraocular muscle is the most common muscle that is involved, and as you can see, the larva is present inside the muscle with the encystation. And what is the most common site? The extraocular muscle are the most common muscles, and the pig is an intermediate host, and the first man is an accidental or the dead end host. Now, moving next to the Onchocerca volvulus. Now, Onchocerca volvulus is mainly present in the West Africa. And if you remember, the two important things about the Onchocerca volvulus is that the person will have the leopard-like skin and it causes the liver blindness. Right? And the test with skin test is Mazotte skin test, and the drug of the choice, we have seen that for the strongyloids and for the Onchocerca, the drug of the choice is not albendazole, it is ivermectin. Okay, now Onchocerca volvulus causes a liver blindness, as you can see. Now, important to remember that liver blindness is caused by the Onchocerca volvulus, and the ivermectin is the drug of the choice. Now, coming to some of the mnemonics to keep remember. Now, N for Neha, that is the non bile stained X are. So non bile stained X by the Neha are the Nikita americans, Antrobius vermicularis, H nana, that is the dwarf tapeworm, and the Ankylostoma. Okay, so it is important to remember Antrobius vermicularis is also known as the pinworm or the thread worm, and the H nana is the dwarf tapeworm, and Nikita americans is what, the new world hookworm, and the Ankylostoma duodenum is the old world hookworm. Right, so Neha, that is the Nikita americans, Antrobius vermicularis, H nana, and Ankylostoma. Now, moving next, eggs that do not float in the saturated salt solution can be remembered by the mnemonic, that is the ALTO. And what is the ALTO? That is the U4 unfertilized egg of the Ascaris, L4 larva of strongyloids, T4 tinea egg, and O4 operculated egg of the trematodes. So remember it by the mnemonic, that is the ORTO. U4 unfertilized egg of the Scaris, L4 larva of the strongyloids, T4 tinea egg, and O4 operculated egg of the trematodes. Now coming to the mnemonic of the autoinfection. Now autoinfection, what has happened, that the parasite completes the life cycle within a single organism, that is the life cycle is completed at the, in case of man, that will develop from the egg to the larva to the adult, and then again the eggs are released and again the person will consume. So this is how the auto infection appears, that is it in such a way that completes the life cycle of the parasite happens in the single organism and without involvement of another host. Therefore, the primary host is at the same time the secondary host for the parasite, right? Now, what are the examples of the this autoinfection? That is the by the mnemonic CHEST, that is C for Cryptosporidium parvum, H for H nana, and E for Antrobius vermicularis, S for strongyloids, and T for Tinea solium. Right, so important to remember the mnemonic for the autoinfection, the examples of the autoinfection: Cryptosporidium parva, H. nana, Antrobius, strongyloids, and the Tinea solium. Now these are the another important disease caused by the lilies, that is the liver rot by the fasciola. And the Katayama fima we read yesterday, that it is caused by the Schistosoma mansoni, hydrated by the echinococcus, and the tropical spinomegaly syndrome by the Plasmodium, black fever by the Leishmania, in elephantitis by the Wuchereria, primary amoebic PAM, that is the free living amoeba, that is Naegleria, cutaneous larva migrans, that is by the Ankylostoma, and the scabies by the Sarcoptes. Now important is the okay, so we have talked already about the drug of the choice for the this nematodes. What are the drug of the choice? And we'll talk in detail about the egg. Brief about the egg we'll be talking about. So before that, just revising the topic. Yes, coming back now. Nematodes, they are what, the N-segmented and cylindrical, that is cystoid, trematode, and the nematode. We saw that these were the segmented and other two were the unsegmented, and nematodes are what, these are cylindrical, and trematodes, they are what, they are leaf like. And and for the drug of the choice was the praziquantel, and here the albendazole, but the exceptions were there, and here also echinococcus, that were the albendazole was a drug of the choice. The trematodes, the larva form was the Metasarcaria. And the cystoid, we made a list for the this larva form. And now coming to the small intestine and the large intestine, we read it by the mnemonic, that before that, the common names: Ascaris lumbricoides is the common roundworm, Ankylostoma is the old world, Necator is the new world, Trichura is the whipworm, Antrobius is the pin and the thread, and Draconanculus is the guinea worm. Now talking about the single intermediate host, we have seen. Now talking about the two intermediate hosts that are present, and the definitive host and the we yesterday read about the Diphyllobothrium, and the another is the Fasciola, Chlornorchis sinensis. Now the definitive host will be men for all of them, can be remembered by the DIFCO, that is the Diphyllobothrium, Fasciola, Chlornorchis, and the Opisthorchis. Now what was the intermediate host? Now for the Diphyllobothrium, it is the Cyclops and the fish. because the infection occurred after the consumption of the larva that was the present in the uncooked fish. And for them, one is the snail, aquatic plant for the fasciola, and for the remaining two, it is the fish that is the second intermediate host, right? So man is a definitive host for all of them, and the fish is the host. Apart from the fasciola, the fish is the second intermediate host, and for the last three, the snail is the first intermediate host. Now, moving next to the intestine, we have seen the light has otio, that is a large intestine. Examples were the Trichura entrobius, and the small intestine has, that is the H for hookworm, A for Ascaris, and the strongyloids, and the otio, that is the oviparous, that is the T for Trichura entrobius, and the Ascaris, and the hookworm, right? And the for the viviparous, two examples, that is the Trichinella and Dracunculus, and the oviparous strongyloids. Now this is the definitive host and the intermediate host. We have seen Plasmodium for the, it is a mosquito, and the Toxoplasma, it is the, for the Plasmodium, Toxoplasma, the Echinococcus, man is not the definitive host. Okay, and for the Leishmania, for the man is the definitive host. For the Leishmania, Sandfly, Trypanosoma, Brucei, and Brucei, for the sleeping sickness, CC fly, and the Crusi by the Reduvic bug, Tinea solium, and the Saginata by the pig and the kettle. O for pork comes O in the pork as well. So pig is for the Tinea solium, Saginata beef. H nana only has one host, and the H diminuta, that is a red flea. Now moving next to the Chandler index. Now Chandler index is used for the hookworm, that is to see the x per gram of the stool, and in case it is below 200, that it is not of much significance. Now this was the infective form was the egg, and the filariform for the strongyloid is the hookworm, and the hyperinfection syndrome due to the heavy filariform larva, and in case the people with the on the glucocorticoid therapy. Now albendazole is the drug of the choice, but what are the exceptions of the this nematodes? That is the one is the Dracunculus and the Antrobius metronidazole, Onchocercus, strongyloids ivermectin, and the Vichuria and the Brugia malai is the diethyl carbamazine. Now this is a rebdiform and the microfilariform larva. Now filariform larva is again the infective form for the filarial nematodes. And what were the examples of the lymphatic filariasis? That is the Vichuria, Brugia malai, and the vector, that is the Culex and Anopheles. Now for the subcutaneous filariasis, the Loa Onchocercosis and the Mansonella, and for the serous cavity filariasis, Mansonella pertens and Marsonella ozardii. Now moving next, just remember that for the Vichuria, the Culex and the Anopheles are the vector, and for the Brugia, the Mansonia is the vector. And the examples of the lymphatic filariasis and the subcutaneous filariasis. Now moving next, the microfilari are the not the pathogenic. We have read about the clinical manifestation, endemic, asymptomatic, acute, and the chronic. Chronic after 10 to 15 years with the elephantiasis. And the characteristics of the classical and the occult O for organ, that is the microfilariform, are not present in the blood, and due to which the organs that are effective, that are lung, liver, and the spleen, and the person will show the hypersensitivity to the microfilariform microfilary antigen, and the eosinophilic granuloma due to hypersensitivity and IgE antibody is a diagnostic, and the occult filariform is also known as Wingartens syndrome. That is the important one more thing, that is the occult organs are involved, that is the no lymph nodes are involved, and the Mayer's Covenant syndrome, that is the tropical pulmonary eosinophilia, is the Mayer's Covenant syndrome. It's also called as the Mayer's Covenant syndrome. Now for the Trichinella, now the pig is the intermediate host and the man is the dead end host. What was the important? That the larva form is present in with X cystation. The larval form undergoes the N cystation, that is converts into the cyst form, and that most common muscle that is involved is the extraocular muscle. And the test we do is the Backman interdermal test for the trichinular spiralis. Remember these two points, that the extraocular muscle is involved and later the biceps and the jaw and the neck, and the test is the Backman interdermal test. Right, and what was the another for the Onchocercus volvulus? The black flies are the vector, and the test here is to remember is the Mazotti skin test we do, and it causes the liver blindness, dermatitis, and leopard skin. And test is important, that the Mazotti skin test we do, and the liver blindness and the leopard skin dermatitis and the black flies are the vector. While for the lower deer flies or chrysops are the vector. And other than this Wuchereria, we have read for the Wuchereria, Culex and the Aedes were the vector, and for Brugia mollis, Mansonia species was the vector. Now coming to the mnemonic, that non-bile cell by the Neha, that is Nikitor americans, Antrobius, H. nana, and Kylostoma. And for the does not float, that is not floating, is the Alto, that is the unfertilized egg of Ascaris, larva of Strongyloid, Stenia, and the operculated egg of the Trematodes. Now for the autoinfection, the mnemonic was the CHESS, that is Cryptosporidium pavum, H. nana, Antrobius, Strongyloids, and the Tenia solium. Now moving next, these were the important disease caused by the helminthes and other the parasites. Now this is the larva migrans. This is the cutaneous larva migrans. Showing the creeping eruptions. As you can see, the cutaneous larva migrans. Now, what helminths do cause the cutaneous larva migrans is hookworm, that is the Ankylostoma, by the nematodes mainly, and Strongyloids stercoralis. Now they are mainly caused by the nematodes, that is the Ankylostoma and the Strongyloids. And thiabendazole is the drug to use for the treatment, and the person will present with the high eosinophilia. Now moving next to the important eggs. Now this is the operculated egg of the Diphyllobatrum latum. Now as we know, the Diphyllobatrum latum LA, that is the largest tapeworm, right, and it has the operculated egg. Operculated egg meaning that it has a lid like structure, that is they have the lid like structure, and it is the operculated egg of Diphyllobatrum latum. Now what are the other examples of the operculated egg? By the TDS, that is T4, all the trematodes, except schistosomiasis in the egg that has the spine and Spirometra and D4 Diphyllobacterium latum. Right, now moving next, this is the egg of Hymenolepis nana. Now the Hymenolepis nana, only one host was present, and the H nana is also known as the dwarf tapeworm. Now they had three pairs of hooks, as you can see, three pairs of hooks, total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 hooks. So total of 6 hooks with polar thickening at one end and polar filament at another end. So this is the egg of H nana. From H as well, that is the hexa hooks, that is the hexacanth hooks, that is the total of 6 hooks are present in H nana. Now another is the difference between the H nana and Diminuta. Now H nana Diminuta, the rat flea is the intermediate host. Now coming to the H nana and the Hymenolepis Diminuta, now the egg measures, the egg size is smaller in compared to the H nana. And while the H Diminuta, they lack the polar filaments. We saw the polar filaments and the polar thickening at one end. Now the polar filaments are absent in the H Diminuta. They both have the 6 hooks, but polar thickening is absent, polar filament is absent in the H Diminuta. Now this is the H Diminuta with the same 6 hooks, that is the 3 pairs of hooks, but no polar thickening at the end, right? Now moving next, yesterday we saw Schistosoma species egg, that is how did we remember that it hematobium, that is the T40, that is the terminal spine is present, and for the Mansoni lateral spine, and for the Japonica ni, that is the nil spine. Right, so Japonica presented with the nil spine, and the Mansoni with the lateral spine, and the hematobium with the hematobium with the terminal spine. And also if you remember the hematobium, they cause the hematuria and the unibladder cancer, that is squamous cell carcinoma. And what is the site of inhabitation? It was the vesicle and the pelvic venous plexus for the hematobium, and for the Mansoni it is the inferior mesenteric vein, and it is causes the swimmer's itch and the schistosomiasis acute and the chronic. And the Japonica, it was the superior mesenteric vein. Now moving next, this is the Fasciola hepatica egg, and it is also operculated egg, but as you can see lid like structure is present, but no knob is present at the end. It is also operculated egg of Fasciola hepatica. Now coming to the Scaris lumbricoides egg, now fertilized and the unfertilized. Now what is the difference between the fertilized and the unfertilized? The chitin and the albumin, the chitin layer and the albumin coat, they are the chitin and the albumin coat, they are thin in the unfertilized egg while they are thick in the fertilized egg. Right, as you can see, like the chitin and the albumin layer, this is the albumin layer and the outermost the chitin layer, they are thick in the fertilized egg, while we cannot easily differentiate in the unfertilized egg because they are thin in unfertilized egg. Now moving next to the egg of the Trichura trichura. Now the Trichura egg, they have the polar thickening at both the ends, that is the polar thickening is present at both the eggs, and egg are what, the lemon shaped egg, barrel shaped egg with mucus plug at both the ends. It is quite easy to remember the Trichura trichura. Now this was about the eggs. that in the diaphragm, it is the operculated duct that is a lid-like structure. Now, other examples of the operculated duct by the mnemonic are TDS, that is the all trematode spirometra and the diaphragm latum. Apart from the cystosomna, not included in the operculated duct, this is the polar thickening of the polar filaments in the H nana, that is the hamelapsis nana, and the H nana is what the dwarf tapeworm, and the H diminuta, that is they lack the polar thickening at the end. Now moving next, this is the H diminuta. Now H diminuta, they also have the six hooks, that is the three pairs of hooks, but no polar thickening. Right, now moving next, cystosomiasis we read yesterday, that is a T4 terminal spine in the hematobium. That is present at terminal spine and the lateral spine in the Mansoni, and Japonica NI, that is the nil spine, is present. And the hematobium causes the hematurians found in the inferior and the pelvic venous plexus, while the Japonica has no spine and it is found in the superior mesenteric vein and the Mansonia and the inferior mesenteric vein and causes the Katayama fever. Now this is again the operculated egg of the fasciola hepatica. Now fertilized and the unfertilized of the egg of the Scaris. Now the unfertilized have the thin chitin and the thin albumin coat. And it is the tritura, that is the branch, this is the lemon shaped or the barrel shaped egg with mucus plug at both the ends, that is the eggs are lemon shaped with plug lactose translucent polar amines at the both the ends. Okay, so this was about the eggs of the helminths. Now we have talked some few mnemonics about. One was the Neha. Neha was for the non bile stained egg. That is the Neha is a non-bile stained egg. N for Nicator americans, Hookworm, Antrobius, and A for Ankylostoma. Another mnemonic we talked about the Alto for the non-floating egg. And Alto, that is unfertilized egg, L for larva of the Strongyloids, T for Tinea, and O for operculated egg of Trematodes. Right, and another mnemonic we saw was the light has othio for the large intestine containing tritura and the antrobius, and has in the small intestine, and it was hook, H for hookworm, A for Ascaris, and S for the strongyloids, and othia, that is the oviparous, T for the tritura, H for the hookworm, E for antrobius, A for Ascaris, and S for Othias. Now strongyloids, that was the example of the oviviparous. We talked about definitive and the intermediate host, and the two intermediate host as well, and albendazole is the drug of the choice for all the nematodes, exceptions with the ivermectin is the drug of the choice for the this Onchocercus and the strongyloids, and mebendazole is the drug of the choice of Antrobius. Right, and the strongyloids, ivermectin and Wuchereria and the Brugia malai, it was the diethyl carbamazine. Right, so these are the important drug of the choice we read today. Now the wrapping of today's session. Okay, so wrapping up today's session, and please do use my code, that is Muskan, to get the 10% of the discount on the NEETP subscriptions. And we will talking about the doing the question answers of the import this parasitology from the parasitology in the special class. And thank you for today's session. And I don't know why the volume was even low today, because I have done some changes, but still if the volume is low, although I'm speaking at my highest voice, I'll do correct it by tomorrow. And now thank you for today's session, and also to use my code, that is Muskan, to get 10% of the discount. And in case you're working as a doctor, so be try to be safe at your workplace, and if not you are a student, so be safe at your and study at home, and be safe at your home. Okay, so thank you and study well.